I'm Tom Ferry, CEO of Ferry International. I've been involved in the real estate industry both from a coaching standpoint, a training and strategy standpoint for 31 years, and I have about 35,000 hours of private coaching sessions under my belt. I used video to build my brand as soon as YouTube came out back in 2007. The simple answer is, if you know who your customer is, if you recognize their pain points, their challenges, their concerns, their worries, but also their ambitions, their desires, you can then begin to frame content, specifically video content, that speaks to that, speaks to their challenges, speaks to their worries, but also provides solutions and insights and guidance. And by doing that for myself on video, I was able to become, early on, one of the most successful people in the space just by doing so. The argument that I make for people when they ask me, why should I use video in my business to build my brand, is I say quite simply, your vibe attracts your tribe, and consumers have a lot of choices of flavors of real estate professionals. We've all heard the phrase before, people like to do business with people that are just like them. So why not put you out and let people get to know who you are, what you stand for, what you're all about, so they can choose you? And better, I'd rather you not go on an appointment with someone that you're not gonna vibe with, that you're not gonna connect with, and you're not gonna like. I'd rather know that upfront, and video does that for us at scale. So the simple answer is, your vibe attracts your tribe, and video is the fastest, easiest, most effective way to put out your unique selling proposition, who you are, what you stand for, who you serve, the markets that you know, the things that you understand, the problems that you can solve, to educate people so they can say, you know what? I like that gal. I get that guy. And look, everyone watching this says, I want come list me calls. Let me give you a little insight. They don't exist. What you actually get when you get that phone call is an I trust you call. Video puts trust at scale. And if I said to you, how much do you want to sell your home for? You got a number. If I say to you, how much money do you need to pay for your daughter's wedding? You got a number, you know. And then I say, how much money do you want to save in your business?
I don't know.
I would argue that consumers are confused every single day as to who they should select to represent them in the most important decision of that year, buying or selling. Selecting the right agent that's gonna get me the right price, that's gonna have a smooth transaction, that's gonna be able to close the deal on the list side, or help me secure the home of my dreams. I argue every day for video being the way that you can put your brand on steroids. You can put your promise on steroids. And whether that video gets 30 views, 100 views, or 10,000 views makes no difference. The person that watches that video understands that you're a professional. They get the connection. Sure, I've got a friend in the business. Sally, who lives next door, she just got her license, but we better talk to Tom Ferry because I watched that video and that guy knows what he's talking about. That's what video does for people. It bridges the gap and helps create more trust amongst potential buyers and sellers, but it also keeps you top of mind with your database.
Do you recall the survey results that I shared with you from that incredible company, Google, where they shared with us the data around how are real estate professionals selected online and off in today's economy? We know that the overwhelming answer is trust. Trust.
In my experience, if you want to create trust, you have to put out content with frequency. No different from Fox News, CNN, MSNBC, whoever your news choice is, right? They align with your message, they align with your beliefs, and you begin to trust them. But what if they were only on once every 45 days? What if they were on once every 6 months? The reality was, because of the lack of frequency, you wouldn't know them as well. You wouldn't invite them into your home. You wouldn't invite them onto your phone if they were only there every 6 months. So frequency is the first thing. Frequency creates familiarity, and that begins to open the door to, I'm open to their ideas. I like what they're saying. I'm connecting with this individual. Video done with great frequency, being authentic, being yourself, right? Not trying to sell, not trying to influence, but just be you. And then guess what? People will say, I like that gal, I like that guy. And that's the beginning of trust. So if you're not doing it with frequency, if you're not putting out a lot of content, it's no different from the person that's on TV once every 6 months. If they're on all the time and I got access to them all the time and they're always bringing me interesting insights or relevant information or things that I want to know more about, whether it's on my phone, on my tablet, or on my screen, I'm going to connect with that person. I'm going to use that person in my life. And that should be the goal of every real estate professional on the planet. For my entire 31 years, I have been obsessed with how do I have my clients generate more business that's coming inbound. So whether that was in the early days with direct mail or with billboards or some form of advertising or being early on digital, but in 2008, 9, 10, and 11, video became the way to scale your brand, right? To be the educator, to become the person that was deemed the mayor of your town. So what video ultimately does is it creates that elusive, I trust you call. I've said it before, people want come list me calls or, hey, I want you to represent me. How do you get that? You put out content, you put out information, you put out yourself, right? You're vulnerable and you share and you give with no expectation. And then you get those, I trust you calls. You get those, hey, you need to call this guy. Hey, watch this video. You're thinking about buying a house? Listen to this guy first. Or you're thinking about selling your house? You've got to check this gal out. That's what video does for you. And people that don't have video, you know what they have to do? They've got to rely on direct mail, that, you know, maybe you send twice a month, maybe. Maybe you send email, but most agents that aren't doing video are also not doing email the way they should, right? So the reality is you're taking so much of your livelihood, your brand, and you're doing this. Come on, seven. And you're hoping and praying that it works. And unfortunately, that's not a strategy in 2020 or beyond that's gonna get you the kind of business that you want. So the word of the day is attribution. Where did this lead come from? And did they find you on Facebook? Was it on Google? Was it, you know, on Zillow? Was it a video? The reality is, unless you have some attribution method, which is basically to help me figure out where this came from, you're gonna struggle to see, did video have the kind of impact that I wanted it to have? So think about this, Google Analytics. That's gonna let you know, right? Having a video that you shoot on a weekly basis that you email to your entire database, that when they open it up, they don't open it up on YouTube, they open it up on your website. So you can see the traffic and know every Tuesday when I send this video out to my 1,000 people, you know, 27% open it, 5% of them click through, and you know, 92% watch the first 2 minutes of the video. And on that, I've got all my CTAs, all my calls to action, join my VIP list, right? Find out about deals in your marketplace or whatever it is you're offering. So the answer is 1000% yes. If you're ambitious and you recognize that there's a 90% failure rate in all small businesses, there's an 87% failure rate in real estate every 5 years. Like the turnover is horrendous. And part of the reason why is it's not a lack of passion and desire, or it's just people just like, you know, man, I could sell a couple houses now and then, and this is better than working at Denny's. So first it's create content. Then you need to think about attribution so you can track intelligently to know the unbelievable impact that video has on your business. I can tell you without a shadow of a doubt, if I was not producing videos on a weekly basis, Mindset Monday, the Tom Ferry Show on Tuesday, right? My podcast on Wednesday, a written blog on Thursday that also gets emailed out, and my vlog on Friday or Saturday. If I wasn't producing that, the amount of interest, top of mind awareness, leads, and revenue would drop dramatically. It's all about attribution, my friend. It's all about attribution. How should you strategically use video to grow your brand and build your business today? The first thing I would say to you is I would create small snippet videos for every if this, then that in my business. So for example, you're on a listing appointment and someone emails you. If you know that's from a specific lead source, that should automatically receive a video back saying, hey, I'm Tom Ferry, Banana Real Estate. I'm currently with a client right now. I'll get back to you in the next whatever time frame is. Something along those lines, especially for after hour videos. So any if this, then that. I would also be thinking through, I'm going on a listing appointment. Traditionally, we would send a pre-listing package. Today, I can send a video that says, hey, Martha and Frank, Tom Ferry, Banana Real Estate. So excited I have the opportunity to come meet with you guys at your home this Tuesday at 4 o'clock. Before we get together, I put together a series of things I'd love for you to review to help you make the best possible decision to market and ultimately sell your home for the highest possible price. Would you just take the time to review below my marketing plan, a few case studies of recent properties, and all these are just links that are included in the email, but I send that video as the opening. We all understand, or maybe you don't, that we're experiencing what's called the epidemic of facelessness. The epidemic of facelessness is we get barraged every day by emails and text. So if I can get a face on there, your face specifically, right? You good looking individual there, your face, the open rates go up. Just test it and watch what happens. So the obvious is all the if this, then that. Those are gonna help you convert more, connect more, right? Be more of that face-to-face resource for the customer, even on this beautiful digital device. That's one. The second part is the phenomenon that we have seen over the last decade of agents finally realizing, if I want to become the agent of choice, if I want to become top of mind, if I want to become on the consideration set for the largest number of prospects in my marketplace, and at the same time, say super top of mind for all my past clients in Sphere, I've got to create a show. Today, I know agents that have two or three shows that they're putting out on a weekly basis. Some of them are using it for recruiting agents. So they're sharing, you know, Tom Tool's tips on ways to be more productive as an agent, as an example. He's doing another show where he's saying, let me educate you on all the steps of a real estate transaction, recognizing that first-time buyers or a seller that hasn't done a transaction in 10 years is a little out of the loop on the complicatedness of a, is that a word? I think it is, of a real estate transaction today. So by educating, you know, what is title insurance and what is escrow and what is the closing costs and how does all this work? Breaking all of that down on a regular basis, again, makes him the educator, the person that I trust, because he's delivering valuable information. If you're in the sales business, if your job, you got to find out what it is your customers really want. And if it's in your wheelhouse to deliver that, deliver that. The point is simply this, there's so much you can do. Know yourself, know your customers, provide value, do it consistently, and you're gonna absolutely crush it in this business. What about video marketing makes sales so much easier? Again, it's like if I get referred by someone, right? Hey, Martha, you gotta use Tom Ferry. He's so charismatic. He's so much fun to work with. He's so detail-oriented. He communicates like nobody's business. He's going to be the right agent for you. Well, I walk into that quote-unquote sales situation almost on a more natural glide path. The challenge is, I can't do that at scale. I can't get enough of my customers to be out there yapping and telling people every single day that they should use me. What video allows me to do is to do that at scale by educating, by doing case studies, by giving examples. Hey, I'm sitting in front of 1234 Banana Street. This home was on the market three times with three different agents. Would it shock you to hear that we raised the price, we repositioned the home, and we were ultimately able to sell it for 98% of list price, absolutely blowing the seller away, getting a five-star review on Yelp, Zillow, Google, whoever you want? You're gonna bring value. You're gonna deliver fresh ideas, new ideas, or maybe just what's going on inside the market and houses. And by doing that, you're gonna win. Videos like that create that glide path for you. Is there a recipe for creating a great video? I would say there are a lot of different recipes. There's not one way. As a matter of fact, I would argue that if you get stuck in a rut of doing the same thing over and over and over and over, just like that, you're in a rut and you're gonna see your viewers drop. So I think you need to pay attention to the cultural norms. You need to pay attention to how consumer behavior is. So today on video, we know the thumbnail is uber important. And if it's like, it's gonna get a better response than just a photo of you looking happy. Big text on the video certainly is gonna produce a better response today. And today in your opening, if you don't metaphorically hook them, AKA punch them in the face and give them a reason to listen beyond that, most people are gonna scooch on to something else because we live in a society packed full of ADD or too many options. So I know today those three are working. As we progress in the future and algorithms change and consumer behaviors change, you must align with it. So my response to you is ABT, always be testing. So stories really are the game. And let's be clear, if I'm talking about a home for sale, that's a story. If I'm talking about a home that was recently closed, that's a story. The more you can create, whether it's the hero's journey or another, against all odds, the sellers put the home on the market and we were able to battle through the experience, close the transaction, adding in, if you will, a little drama, a little excitement, a little intrigue, right? Hooking them with, and guess what happened? All of that is gonna make a big difference.
Send it to me, and then you know you can write a little note and say, yes. Hey, 50 businesses have asked me to do this, and right? Because I'll tell the story, because you're doing exactly what I want people to
know.
You create something where they go, that guy, he's the dancing guy, he's that, right?
And that's all they want to know.
So there is a plethora of books and videos and things you can watch on the art and science of storytelling. I would encourage you to just go to YouTube, watch 3 or 4 videos, and then just start to test it. The simple thought is, needs to be a compelling opening, right? You gotta give something that hooks them, that makes them want to listen, want to watch, want to pay attention, right? I saw a just sold video recently and literally the video started like this, $50,000, you're welcome. That was the opening of the video. And what was he saying? I just sold this property for $50,000 above the last comp, implying I brought you $50,000 in equity to your property. You're welcome. Cocky? Maybe. Did it get people's attention? Absolutely. Did I love it? For sure. The bottom line is, whatever you're posting has got to be stop worthy. Hashtag that. Stop worthy. Like, it's got to punch me in the face. It's got to be like, bam, like, oh my God, I'm looking at all this stuff and suddenly I'm going to stop on your stuff. Then you've got to give them some stories, right? Some background, some details, some information that hooks this. Then maybe a little bit of the body of how you got there, the trials, the tribulations, the ups, the downs, or the 3 things you should do, or the 5 mistakes to avoid, etc. And then you got to put a bow on at the end and close it. I was not a great storyteller in the beginning. What I discovered was there was formulas that I could follow. And once you start to play with it and mess around with it and get the feedback and get people's responses, then you realize stories, that's the whole game. The easiest thing an agent can do to get started is to grab their phone and start documenting, whether it's on Facebook or Instagram stories or YouTube stories, which aren't as popular yet. LinkedIn, I believe, just launched their version of stories. So whatever platform your clients are on the most and you're on the most.
Very, very successful agent in New Jersey sends me a screenshot, get this, and I see clearly it's a Tom Ferry ad, ready, on Tinder. She's like, you're following me everywhere. I'm like, you're on Tinder.
Document your journey. 5, 6 videos, stories, examples throughout the day. That's a great way to start. I would also encourage you to look at doing Ask Me Anything, posting that on an Instagram story. And then instead of just text the answer, which I admittedly do a lot of, you should do video answers. So someone says, hey, I heard that interest rates, you can get something at like 1.99%. Is that true? Here's how you have to make that happen. And a more traditional 30-year fix is probably gonna put you at X if you're sharing on video answers to questions that matter to people. You do that, you're gonna win. So that would be the very beginning. The next one, if you really, really wanna kill it, I would say to you, go to the 3 or 4 local colleges in your town and post on their job board looking for experienced videographer who wants to build up their resume working with a professional real estate agent in town, creating content on a weekly or monthly basis. And guess what you're gonna find? 3 or 4 guys and gals are gonna say, hey, I'm interested, what does that look like? I don't wanna shoot listing videos, I don't have time because I'm working and I'm doing college, plus blah, 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 great. Can we meet once a month and just create 4 original pieces of content? And if you don't know what content to create at this point, you have other issues. I mean, all you have to do is go YouTube, real estate, you know, best video topics of 2020, and you'll know everything you should shoot on. Hey, what's up, my friends on YouTube? It's been a while since I've gone live here, but listen, I want to just let you know, we are doing a flash sale for tickets for my Success Summit. If you're like me and you want to go all in, you want to make not only 2020 the balance of the year, right? You want to make it right. But it's about creating the structure. That's really what I'm saying to you. The structure of your day already exists, just documenting that. And then finding that wonderful former wedding videographer who's free, you know, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday to come to your office and spend an hour with you a week or, you know, 3 hours with you a month to film some content, get it professionally packaged, a bumper in the front, a bumper at the end, some text on it, maybe create some snippets for, you know, Instagram and others, and boom, you're in the game. The reason why most people won't do it is because they'll say, how do I do it? And that's where you're in trouble. I believe what's stopping people from getting started with video would best be described as the resistance, written in a book called The War of Art.
I've never experienced this other than doing this intermittent fasting where I literally feel like my body is burning.
What stops people is the voice in their head that says, no one's gonna care. No one wants to watch me. I don't like how I look on video. I don't even have time for this. I'm so busy. And 7,000 other excuses that you will die a slow death in your grave because you never understood that the game of life is to hear that crap and do it anyway. Those are the people that experience joy in life. The people that are interested in video might do it if it's convenient, but the resistance is gonna stop them. The voice in their head's gonna stop them. Be really clear. Everyone already knows what you look like, so you're not gonna shock them, right? And no one cares. And people already select you. People already choose to work with you, not because of your appearance, not because of your hair, not because of your glasses. They choose you because they trust something about you. Maybe it's your smiling eyes. Maybe it's the fact you've got a calming tone. Maybe it's because you just take the time to sit and listen. Video lets me put all of that to work at scale and find way more people. They're gonna say, you know what? I like that gal. I like that guy. So ask yourself this question. This is the real thing you don't get. It's not video. It's everything in your life that gets stopped by that chatter in your head. Think about it. Do I ask that guy, you know, hey, go on a date with me, that gal, go on a date with me? Do I ask my job, you know, my boss for a raise? Do I say to my wife or my spouse, I don't like when you do that? It's what stops you everywhere. Video is just the expression of it today. I challenge you. TikTok, TikTok, go to Google today, type in death calendar, fill out the information, and very quickly you realize life is super short. Life is super short. And the question is, are you going to live? And video is just an expression of that, just like asking for a raise or saying to someone, will you go out with me on a date or telling your spouse what you like or making a decision about your health and vitality? Or are you gonna die that slow, painful death, TikTok, TikTok, Google death clock, and just watch the whole thing fade away? Just be another person that lays there on their deathbed saying, man, I wish I would have. Video is just the expression of, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna put myself out there. I'm gonna make it happen. It's not just video, my friend, it's everything. I'm just telling you, life is really short. Life is really short. Get your ass out there. You're gonna die anyway, so you might as well have some fun and experience some eustress and some stress. So if you just need one more reason to do video, let me share a story. I've had several mentors in my life that have passed away in the last 5 years. And the one thing I wish more than anything else, beyond them just being here, that I could just call and say, Bill, I miss you and I need some advice. Or, hey, let's go for a walk. Or, Mike, you know, what should I do in this situation? These people that were so influential in my life, the one thing I wish beyond them being alive today would be that they would have taken the time to do way more video. Now you think, Tom, God, okay, video, I get it. No, think about it. Do you realize, had they taken the time to put themselves out there, to share their wisdom, to share their insight, to share their thoughts on business, on relationships, on life, on health, the things that made these men so special and so important for me, I would be sharing all of that with my boys. I'd be sharing it with all my friends. I would want to give their gift to everyone. And I think to myself, I'm going to die one day. The difference is, when I pass away, my kids, my grandkids, my nieces and nephews, my great-great-grandkids will probably be able to go to a device and say, what was he like? Oh my goodness, there's 10,000 videos here. Yeah, some of them he was talking about like real estate sales training, some he was talking about motivation, but you know what? Like, I understand who he is and I understand how the family tree was shifted because of all this crazy work that he did, because he met some guy on a golf course in 2007 that worked at Google and said, you should check out YouTube. I'm telling you, video is more about your legacy. It's more about giving back to the community and to the family and friends and loved ones in your marketplace forever. Stop being so selfish. Stop being so selfish to think you will die one day with all that wisdom in your head and never put it out. Oh, sure, you'll say, I'll write a book. Well, guess what? If I had a dollar for every person that told me they were gonna write a book, I'd have a lot more dollars. This is far easier. Hey, it's Tuesday the 27th of whatever year it is, and today I'm thinking about this. And just sharing your thoughts and posting it on YouTube. It could be that simple, or it could be, let me show you my brand new listing at 1234 Banana Street. And literally 100 years from now, your great-great-grandchildren will go, Grandma did what? I watched all these videos. She was the bomb. Remember when they used to drive cars? She had a car too. It was insane. What was that thing in her hand? And people will know you forever. I'd say that's pretty significant. If not just for your business today, for the people that you love and the people that love you and the people that you don't even know yet that are part of your family. That's how cool I think video is. It's not just about a come list me call or an I trust you call. It's about your legacy. I dare you to start documenting it.